was slick.
What to finish?
That was slick.
That was
what
beautiful. To finish? He slid out of the way. Oh, nice little butterfly sweep there, but he's giving up a guillotine.
Oh, this is trouble!
You don't want to give your neck to Garry Tonon. He's going to keep adjusting until he finds it. But some
like this drop down to featherweight. Ooh, nice little right hand. Expect Garry Tonon to spend some time on the feet. Watch his head movement. Watch how he bobs to the left and right. Looks a little bit like Mike Tyson out there, changing the levels, mixing things up. He's going to drop down, threaten the takedown, but I think he wants to get experience on the feet. I think he wants to get some rounds in and just earn his pedigree on the feet.
Plenty of early switch stances here from Garry Tonon between southpaw and orthodox. Sung Jong Lee does have dynamite in his hands. We've seen him explode before. He tries for an overhand right. Tonon, long reach on the jab, now goes southpaw, back to orthodox. He'll keep switching. He'll look for ways to confound the Korean.
Sung Jong Lee doesn't really have that knockout power, but he punches together very well. I'm not really digging how Garry Tonon's lifting that back leg up when he throws that right hand, but he goes right into the takedown.
And here we are on the ground in Tononville.
Sung Jong Lee, look at him. He's lacing the legs. You can see Garry Tonon knows exactly what he's trying to do. He's trying to, as you can see, Sung Jong Lee was trying to wrap those legs around, going to what's called an ashigarami, but Garry Tonon was having nothing of it. Back up to his feet.
Sung Jong Lee had to put on the X guard to prevent the rising knees from Tonon. 8-week camp for Garry Tonon, focused on his boxing and his shoot boxing, working specifically on his jab. Tonon also said this one doesn't go past two rounds. Sung Jong Lee also an 8-week camp, worked on his boxing, wrestling and takedown defense. Tonon's arms looking massive tonight. Those deltoids like a bunch of bananas. Threads the lead hand again. There's an uppercut off the rear hand from Tonon.
Yeah, Tonon looks sharp at this new weight class. Doesn't seem to be affected by the new weight cut.
Just small cut under the left eye there of Tonon, Mitch.
Looks a little bit like it, but I'd like to see, you know, Sung Jong Lee start going after those legs.
Uppercut almost took out the ring lights there from Tonon. Lots of boxing from the American here in the first round. Uppercut again misses the target. High up on the balls of his feet, fires a front kick to the face. Strikes not landing here for Tonon. Plenty of movement from him, goes down to the bread basket, then back up to the jawline. Front kick to the guts there from Tonon. Right hand just needed to turn it through a little more. Left hook from Tonon, it's all handiwork. It's got one very loud fan in the audience here, Mitch, Garry Tonon.
I think Garry Tonon's got a lot of fans all over the world that are screaming at their TV sets right now, yelling that he needs to go for that takedown again.
Front kick there from Tonon. Patience being shown from Sung Jong Lee. Inside leg kick to that femoral profunda there from Tonon. You can see the blood just coming down the left cheek of Tonon. Good right hand from Sung Jong Lee. As Tonon continues to switch stance, another uppercut misses the target.
See, he's got a little bit of damage on his face right there. He seems to be wearing it well, though. I'd like to see Sung Jong Lee start going after the leg kicks. He's not really throwing any kicks so far, so he's only giving Garry Tonon one thing to think about, and that's boxing.
Mitch, for a man in only his third match, he looks tremendously confident, poised, precise, and enjoying himself, Garry Tonon. It's just how good he looks at this stage of his career.
I mean, it's... Yes, but he's also got a lot. Oh, that's a beautiful sweep right there. He stepped in, hooked the leg, threw him on the canvas. But Sung Jong Lee was able to pop right back up. Garry Tonon has competed in hundreds of wrestling matches and hundreds of grappling matches, so he knows what it's like to be on the big stage. But under the ONE Championship lights, we gotta say he is performing exceptionally well, very relaxed, extremely confident.
I mean, even the way he just locked on the Muay Thai clinch and the high knee earlier on, putting together all the weapons in the mixed martial artist's arsenal. Garry Tonon, superb thus far. 35 seconds on the clock. Dances off in a clockwise fashion. Now drifts counterclockwise. Peppers out the jabs again.
The stance is constantly switching from Garry Tonon, and it's very hard for Sung Jong Lee to get a read on it. He's having a hard time timing his punches as Garry Tonon closes the distance.
I think that Sung Jong Lee expected Tonon to come out striking. We all guessed that he would, but the effectiveness of Tonon's jab so far has been superb.
His head movement, look at the way he's pivoting around. He's moving his head very well.
Cut.
And he's got lots of energy, even though as he's dropping, he's got to put that jab out there. He's got, as Garry Tonon's closing the distance, Sung Jong Lee's got to utilize the jab. Garry Tonon is usually like throwing way too many jabs.
Counter right hand there from Sung Jong Lee. The head movement again from Tonon. The boxing has improved out of sight, particularly the jab of Tonon. High up again on the balls of his feet, working the kicking arsenal now. There's a front kick to the midsection from the American. Dances back to center cage. Outside leg kick, inside leg kick. A striking display here, 101 from Garry Tonon.
This is a very different striker from the second time that we saw him.
You know what, Mitch, we're seeing the kicks here from Tonon, but Sung Jong Lee began his martial arts career in the national Korean art of Taekwondo, an art renowned for its kicking arsenal.
And he hasn't thrown a kick yet.
Nope. 2016 Naganogi Grappling Championship at under 160 pounds. Sung Jong Lee, purple belt in BJJ, loves the heel hook. Imagine slapping a heel hook on Garry Tonon. Don't think it'll happen. But let's see if he can swing for a knockout here in the second round. Garry Tonon, look at the movements on Tonon. Circles off clockwise, now drifts to his right. Full of confidence oozing out of every pore here for Garry Tonon. The jab, oh, look at the evasion and the takedown. That was sweet.
What to finish?
That was slick.
That was beautiful. He slid out of the way. Oh, nice little butterfly sweep there, but he's giving up a guillotine.
Oh, this is trouble!
You don't want to give your neck to Garry Tonon. He's going to keep adjusting until he finds it. But Sung Jong Lee did a good job there of swinging over into half guard. Got into side control, but look at Garry Tonon. He adjusted it in. Oh, that's it.
Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some Tonon in it.
Garry Tonon.
3-0, a 100% finishing rate, competing at featherweight tonight. And he looked absolutely superb.